So starting us off tonight will be David Diamond. And following David will be Cheryl Peralt. So go ahead and unmute yourself, David.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay, sorry about that. Zoom locked up on me. Bill Gates hates me, you know. Here we go. I thought I'd do a song in my genuine fake American accent. So. There is a man you hear about most in a place you go. His whole name's in Texas, and his name is Diamond Joe. And he carries all his money in a diamond-studded jaw. And he never was much bothered by the process of the law. I hide out to Diamond Joe, boys. I give him my right hand. He give me a string of horses so they could not stand. I like to starve to death, boys. He did mistreat me so. And I never saved a dollar in the pay of Diamond Joe. His bread was corn dodgers, his meat I could not chew. He drove me near distracted with the wagging of his jaw. By the telling of this story, I aim for you to know. Never was a rounder could lie like Diamond Joe. I tried three times to quit him, boys. He did argue so. And I'm still punching cattle in the pay of Diamond Joe. And when I'm called up yonder and it comes my time to go, give my blanket to my buddy, give the fleece to Diamond Joe.
Love it. Give the fleas to Diamond Joe.
Good job.
Love that one.
Yeah.
Great old tune.
Although I got to say, the American accent didn't really come across.
I thought it was pretty good.
You did? Yeah. Okay.
Depends which part of America you come from. I come from the North London part.
Right. Was not the standard mid-Atlantic accent. Okay, thanks, David. Up next is going to be Cheryl Peralt, and following Cheryl will be Benigno Rodriguez. So go ahead, Cheryl.
Okay, I lost my poem.
You lost your poem.
Let's see. It was ready. There we go. Okay. Are you still there?
We are still here.
Go ahead. We are still here.
Okay. I wrote this poem titled The Mothership a number of years ago after 9/11 in response to sending troops over to Afghanistan, being a mother of young children, feeling like many, very upset in thinking about going to war. And as a poet looking for superheroes, I make reference to Independence Day and also Dr. John Mack, who I had heard at a Psychology of Spirituality conference, maybe a couple years before. And I quote him as an epigraph to this poem at the beginning, which says, "In the end, the abduction phenomenon seems to me to be a part of the shift in consciousness that is collapsing duality and enabling us to see that we are connected beyond the earth at a cosmic level. No common enemy will unite us, but the realization of a common source might." Mothership. Maybe it wouldn't be so bad if we were invaded by alien beings after all, just like in the movie Independence Day. With a giant mothership hovering above like a quiet dark cover of unexpected extraterrestrial blanket with the motor running. At any minute, this new unknown entity might be ready to release the hatches and send out hundreds of small, twirling, purring spaceships commandeered by many-eyed beings with malleable, glowing bodies, whose voices might ring like the singing bowls of Tibet in announcing their arrival. Perhaps they'd make the spacecraft spin off to every single corner of this world, and we'd fear that they might take us captive in one way or another. How then the fear of facing what we don't know might frighten us into instant necessary union. To forget our prior propensity for infectious infighting preoccupations of this being human and civilized. And suddenly we might lose sight of all the things we'd previously been so busy fighting for. Like the warring factions of East and West, like the Cold War links of North and South, like the missiles and ticking bombs riding in backpacks of those who feel certain, like the giant explosive devices intended for high rises in airplanes, like the supersonic bursts of mushroom poison that might descend over entire countries, like the constant battle of armed soldiers marching on tired feet, aiming with dusty weapons or slashing at each other while trying to draw lines of division on the Earth's beautiful lands, or at each other. As vicious wars between those striking out at each other over battlefields or within one family at the dining room table with vicious tongues and dinner knives. Whether differences are within one hating family or one nation or beyond, all of this resulting in many, many battle wounds, afflicting and recycling and restricting generations of civilizations in future possibility of ever feeling, receiving, feeling, or conceiving of the possibility of being at peace and unified. How all of this, whether differences are within one angry family or one hating nation, disputing over who is right or whose beliefs should be followed, when no one here really, really knows or can say what in this life is ever certain, when all of this necessary hating and hacking and howling and warring might suddenly vanish like a thin vapor of clear morning precipitation, as we look instead to the new, heavy, thick, mysterious murk of cloud that lurks from above, with the engines all revving, looking down on us. And we don't know where it comes from, and we don't know where it might take us, or if it is intending to be friend or foe or salvation. How we might only then, like a quiet, perfect miracle, look to each other not for hate, but only for hope. That union offers, and of our new determination from that point on, in making every single breathing moment in our existence under that mothership really matter. Thank you.
really powerful.
Thank you, Cheryl. That was very powerful, very timely. Thank you for that. Okay, up next, it's going to be Benigno Rodriguez, and following Benigno will be Tom Maynard. So go ahead and unmute yourself, Benigno. There you go.
Okay. Is this on? The sound is okay?
It's on. You sound okay. I mean, I can hear you.
You hear me?
Yep.
Perfect.
Thank you. Had a momentary drop out there. I was afraid we'd lost you, but other than that, it sounded good. It's an amazing thing is that it works at all from down there in Uruguay. So it sounded good. Thank you.
Yeah, great job.
So up next is going to be Tom Maynard, and following Tom will be Snake. So Tom, you can unmute since I just muted you.
I am unmuted, I think.
You are.
Excellent. Excellent. Thanks, Dan. And, you know, I probably overstate this, but I don't think it can be overstated. I'm really, really grateful for this group of people. Dan, you're leading us every other week and all the other virtual open mics as well. But it's just so great to be able to get together And I think it's still instrumental, pun intended, in keeping my sanity here. So this is, I apologize to folks who've been on the last two open mics that I've performed in. This is going to be a repeat. This is Leon Redbone's version of Irving Berlin's Walkin' Stick. Without my walking stick, I'd go insane. I can't look my best, I feel undressed without my cane. Must have my walking stick, 'cause it may rain. When it pours, can't go outdoors without my cane. If I ever left my house without my walking stick, well, that would be something I could never explain. Well, the thing that makes me click on Lover's Lane would go for naught if I were caught without my cane. Beep up, bop, bodalum, beep up, bodalum, bop, 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 la-da-dum, re-pop-a-dee-ay, rop-a-dee-bum, rop-a-dee-bum, dee-dee-dee-ah, ra-da-da-dum. If I ever left my house without my walking stick, well, that would be something I could never explain. Oh, the thing that makes me click on Lover's Lane would go for naught if I were caught without my cane. Me bop bop da da lum, be bop bitty bum, bop bitty hey, rop bitty bum, rop bitty dum, ra da da something like that.
Good job.
Always love that one.
Thank you.
Good picking and sounding kind of leonish. Whatever the right adjective there is. Thanks, Tom. Okay, up next is Snake Gullickson, and following Snake will be Ruth Canonical. So Snake, you can unmute. There you go.
Evening, everybody. This is a song written in 1937 by one of my favorite songwriters, Cole Porter. In the still of the night, as I gaze from my window at the moon in its flight, my thoughts all stray to you. In the still of the night, while the world is in slumber, for the times without number, darling, when I say to you, do you love me as I love you? Are you my life going to be? My dream come true. Or will this dream of mine fade out of sight like the moon growing dim on the rim of a hill in the chill still of the night. I love you. Are you my life to be? My dreams come true. Or will this dream of mine fade out of sight like the moon growing dim on the rim of a hill in the chill still of the night.
Nice.
Thank you very much.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Job as always.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you, Snake. That was beautiful. Up next is Ruth Canonico, and following Ruth will be Doug Danforth. So, Ruth, you can unmute yourself. There you are.
I hope you can hear me because I have to sit far from the computer because I have to put my feet on my dulcimer case. In order to put my dulcimer on my knees. So I'm going to sing something I haven't sung for many years. When I first was in college to study music and voice, I told the teacher that I could not do opera. And fortunately for me, this is the brief introduction, he was from Kentucky, my teacher. I was in Indiana to do the studies. And he knew John Jacob Niles when he was still living. If anyone doesn't know who that is, he was a collector of Appalachian mainly ballads, which many of which are child ballads. So I'm going to make an attempt at singing the first one I learned. Sorry, I'll try it again. Oh, she was a lass from the low country, but he was a lord of high degree, and she loved his lordship so tenderly. Oh, sorrow, sing sorrow, for she sleeps in the valley where the wild flowers nod, and no one knows she loved him but herself and God. One day when the sun was on the mead, he rode past her gate on a milk-white steed. She smiled and she spoke, but he paid no heed. Oh, sorrow, sing sorrow, for she sleeps in the valley where the wild flowers nod. But no one knows she loved him but herself and God. So if you be a lass from the low country, don't love you no lord of high degree, for he ain't got a heart for sympathy. Sorrow, sing sorrow, for she sleeps in the valley where the wild flowers nod, and no one knows she loved him but herself and God. Lass from the Low Country.
Thank you.
That was gorgeous.
Yeah, oh, beautiful.
Yes. Beautiful old ballad. Yes, thank you. Okay, so thanks for that, Ruth. Up next is Doug Danforth, and following Doug will be Bev Tappan. And I just muted you, Doug. I just unmuted you, so go ahead. Oops. There you go.
Right. This is going to be a guitar duet from the Renaissance era. It's called A Lesson for Two Lutes. I'll be playing this along with my ever-willing guitar partner, who is me. Can't get away from myself. What I did, I recorded one part, and I'll play the other part along with it. So, the only difficulty, if I ever hesitate, my partner doesn't wait for me. It just keeps right on going. Oops, I gotta play the other part. Oop, gotta get that started. Sorry about that.
Gorgeous. Didn't drop a note. No, it sounded great, Doc. That's a challenge. Thank you.
For something of that period, it was interesting to have that little seventh in there on, I think it was the A chord. Really nice piece, though. Well done.
Yeah. Thank you.
I don't know what your harmony is.
Okay, so up next is Bev Tappan. And I do not see Greg, so following Mom will be Woody. So Mom, you can unmute, and then we'll see whether we can make this thing work.
Okay. We're showing a piece on YouTube that Dan's youngest sister decided to compose the music for one of my poems, and that she and I would present this to her church talent night, which we did. So I read the poem first, and then we sing, and I harmonize a little, and we do the musical version, which she composed. So can you put the YouTube on, Dan?
is this the right one? Because I think this one starts with her singing.
Well, that's okay. If you're sure about that, I can read the poem first.
And poem meant to be heard, right? That's the right one, right?
No, that's not the one we're doing.
That's not that's the one you sent me.
Oh dear.
Let's
see if I can find that. It's a poem meant to be heard.
That's the one that, that's the one you sent me, yeah.
Oh dear. Sorry about this.
Which one did you want? The one from...
What I was expecting was placements.
Let me just see if I can find that one. Hold on. So placement?
Placements.
Lots of things by that name. Are they okay? I found a placements. Izzy, it happened to freeze with you. Okay, hold on.
Wow.
Okay, I got it. I got it.
Wow, you're a miracle worker.
Let me try. Okay, let's see what the rest of the miracle can work. I'm going to try to share that. Okay, can everybody see that video there? Can you, Mom, can you see that?
That's Izzy. Okay.
Okay.
I guess that's it. I don't know.
Where is parking lot that they face, I see compadres come and go.
This the one?
Yeah, but it left out
and
first.
Gaze upon the evening.
Can you stop it and let me read the poem first?
Yes. I can try.
Yeah, I'll try.
Parking lot.
It's not letting me stop it there. Go ahead and read.
Okay. This was a poem that I wrote about the things that my late partner and I had done. I've grown accustomed to this space, these two big rooms. Just lost my place. I've grown accustomed to this space. These two big rooms I shared with you, where in the parking lot they face, I see compadres come and go. We shared small places, you and I, two-person tents on riverbanks, the back porch of a double wide, youth hostels where we flung our packs. But we shared larger spaces too, the canyon's depths, the river's run, the prairie's breadth, the ocean's blue, the broad earth was our living room. Now you have sought a distant star while I am lightly tethered here. And then she sings that.
Okay.
Song start with that.
Let's try that.
Where in the parking lot? See compadres come and go and gaze upon the evening stars. Now stars. Now
That was worth it. That was great.
Yeah, beautiful.
Love to hear you sing, Bev.
Thank you, Bev.
And my daughter's very talented, too.
No kidding.
Okay. So, yeah, that was beautiful, Mom. Thank you for arranging that. Okay, so up next, where are we? Okay, up next is going to be Woody. And following Woody will be Ergo Canto. So go ahead and unmute Woody.
All righty.
There you go.
It's a song I've been working on. I kind of found it in my archives here. That, you know, you hear a tune in your head and you play it, and then you put it in your file, and then you forget about it for 3 years, and then it pops up again. You say, oh, I remember that, but I don't remember it. So here's what I get of it anyway.
Yeah, beautiful. So cool.
Great job. Wish I could play like that. Okay, so thanks, Woody. Up next, Ergo Canto, Paul, you can unmute yourself, and then following them will be Ellen.
Okay, I think I'm unmuted.
You are. A little bit.
What?
You're a little bit faint. Your volume's a little bit low.
Volume's a little low?
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's not. let me check the level, because it's, let's see, I'll go up here to preferences. Make sure it's picking up the right one. Audio fast track. Is that any better?
It's not great, but I mean, I can hear you, but it's a little bit low still.
Oh, that's weird. I don't know why. If I go right on the mic, it's,
That's fine.
Okay. So I'll just go right on the mic and hopefully you'll hear everything. Let me hit back to get out of this settings thing. Okay. Anyway, we were practicing the other day, and I pulled this one out and threw in the last verse, which somebody invented in the 60s, and Leslie thought it was apt for today. Okay. Okay, I'm going to stop and just ask, was the guitar level too much or about right?
No, the guitar was about, sounded good to me. The guitar and the flute sound good together.
Okay, so we'll see how it goes with my vocal. I'm just going to eat the mic in that case. Old Mr. Johnson had troubles of his own. He had a yellow cat that wouldn't leave its home. He tried and he tried for to give that cat away. He gave it to a man going far, far away. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back. They thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, just wouldn't stay away. He ran around the corner, swore he'd kill that cat on sight. He loaded up his shotgun with nails and dynamite. He waited and he waited for the cat to come around. 97 pieces of that man was all we found. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back. We thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, just wouldn't stay away. Gave it to a little boy with a dollar note, told him for to take it up the river in a boat. They tied a rock around its neck, must have weighed 10 pounds. Now they drag the river for a little boy that's drowned. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back. We thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, just wouldn't stay away. He gave it to a man going up in a balloon, and he told for to take it to the man up in the moon. That balloon came down, it was 90 miles away, where that man is now. Nobody can say, but the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back. We thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, just wouldn't stay away. Gave it to a man who was going way out west, and he told it for to give it to the one he loved the best. First the train, it hit the curve, then it jumped the rail. Not a soul was left behind to tell that gruesome tale. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back. We thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, just wouldn't stay away. Well, the atom bomb fell just the other day. The H bomb fell in the very same way. Russia went, Ukraine went, then the USA. The human race was dead and gone, without a chance to pray. But the cat came back the very next day. The cat came back. We thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, just wouldn't stay away.
Yeah.
I haven't heard that one in a long time. Great job.
First time I heard that song was at Boy Scout camp. I was probably 12.
Well, I'm not sure.
And I don't think they did that last verse, though. I don't recall the last verse from that, though.
The last verse was added in the 60s. It was in the height of the, you know, Cold War. And
yeah, just I remember.
Did a little tweaking of it for today.
Yeah, well, that was after, but still. Just not appropriate for Boy Scout camp, probably. Okay, thanks for that, guys. Up next is going to be Ellen. And then following Ellen will be Deb Goss. So let me unmute Ellen.
Okay.
Yep, you're set.
It was wonderful to hear you guys just played. We've done a lot together with him. This is a song that the title is It All Comes Down to You. And Alan, who comes to all of these things and he's here, even if you don't see him, he's right here. And at one point, I think quite a while ago, Alan was doing a lot of cooking. And I made a song out of that. So the song is called It All Comes Down to You, sitting over there. The peace I find within, the joy I feel inside, I'm so happy, even when I'm blue, it all comes down to you. The answer is your cooking. It all comes down to you. Well, we're coming down the road. You're all I ever need. You're my loving daddy, and you play to make me happy. You are my satisfaction, and I'm so happy for you. I'm gonna eat well every day if it all comes down to you. Thank you. your stockings and flowers are there too. Butter in my biscuit makes me cry and smile. Hot peckers in my cheese, and who knows what else will come with the meat. And I just love to feel good on a dark and stormy day. Hot fudges on my vanilla makes the clouds just go away. You're Mr. Satisfaction. You make up a wicked bread. I'll show you every way that I know and know what I can do for you. It all comes down to you. Thank you.
Great song, Ellen. Thank you.
It was a long time ago.
Thank you, Ellen.
And we're long. Thank you.
Thank you. It's a great song.
Lovely.
Yes. Okay. So up next is Deb Goss, and following Deb will be Greg Algieri. So Deb, you can unmute.
Well, this is an interesting segue because I also have a song of praise that is quite different. It's for President's Day. And some of you know I like really obscure stuff, and this is really obscure, except that you can find it on Spotify because it's on my CD of abolition songs. Anyway, it was written in, it looks like it would have had to have been written probably at the beginning of, or published at the beginning of 1865, prior to the month of April. Anyway, this is for President's Day. Hail, Father Abraham, faithful and true. Through our long night of peril, we've trusted to you to guide through the tempest our good ship of state, to save her from ruin, to rescue her freight, to save her from ruin, to rescue her freight. Stand, Father Abraham, faithful and true, our lives and our hopes we've trusted to you, for we know thy true heart and thy firm, steady hand. By the help of Jehovah, we'll bring us to land. When the thunders of war rent the dark, gloomy sky, and the storm-driven billows were tossing us high, threatening each moment our craft to overwhelm, each gleam of the lightning showed thee at the helm. Each gleam of the lightning showed thee at the helm. Stand, Father Abraham, faithful and true, our lives and our hopes we've trusted to you. For we know thy true heart and thy firm, steady hand. By the help of Jehovah, will bring us to land. And when safe at last on the peaceful shore, we've anchored to ride, tempest tossed no more. Good pilot, thy name and thy memory blessed in the nation's affections forever shall rest. In the nation's affections forever shall rest. Stand, Father Abraham, faithful and true, our lives and our hopes we've trusted to you. For we know thy true heart and thy firm, steady hand. By the help of Jehovah, will bring us to land.
Must have been nice to be able to sing that about a president. Yeah. And unfortunately, it didn't turn out that well.
Yeah. So that was written during the Civil War?
It was written after. It would have been written after the war was. I mean, it could. It's just weird because the war was over. The surrender between the surrender and between Lincoln's assassination wasn't
like
very long.
Yeah.
It was really, really fast. So either they knew something, or I don't know. This was written by a man named Burdick, and I can't find out anything about him. But Mr. Stillman wrote the tune, and it was to be done by a large chorus. It's got a whole choral arrangement. So I spared you
okay.
that.
Well, thank you. A little history lesson and a great song. Thanks, Deb. Okay, up next is somebody, this is his first time here, so we should give him a big welcome. I've seen him at another open mic, but I'm pretty sure this is his first time at this one. So up next is Greg Algieri. Am I pronouncing that right, Greg? And following Greg will be Ron Carlson. So Greg, you can unmute yourself. You are unmuted. Go ahead.
Okay. Thank you very much, Dan. Yep. And you got it right. So, yeah, thank you very much. Thanks for having me. And it's great to be here. And we'll see if we can. I don't have a presidential song, but... We'll do one here. I was surfing around on YouTube, as we all do from time to time, and I've come across I play mostly bluegrass and bluegrass gospel kind of music, and I came across a group that I really like called the Isaacs. It's a family group, and they do a bunch of bluegrass and bluegrass gospel, but they did a cover of this song, which is actually a song that was done a while back. If you remember that group, the Judds, and this is a song that they did and became popular, and it's called Grandpa Tell Me About the Good Old Days. Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Sometimes it feels like this world's gone crazy, and Grandpa, take me back to yesterday, when the line between right and wrong didn't seem so hazy. Did lovers really fall in love to stay and stand beside each other come what may? Was a promise really something people kept, not just something that they'd say and then forget? Did families really bow their heads and pray? Did daddies really never go away? Whoa, whoa, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. And Grandpa, everything is changing fast. We call it progress, but I just don't know. And Grandpa, let's wander back into the past and paint me a picture of long ago. Lovers really fall in love to stay, stand beside each other come what may. Was a promise really something people kept, not just something that they say and then forget? Did families really bow their heads to pray? Did daddies really never go away? Whoa, whoa, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Families really bow their heads and pray. Daddies really never go away. Whoa, whoa, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Whoa, whoa, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days.
Great song.
Good song.
Great Thank job you. With it, too. Thank you. Sounded good. Okay, so up next is Ron Carlson, and following Ron will be Charlie and maybe Melissa. And Ron, and you need to unmute, or I need to unmute. There you go.
So I'm playing this on this old D18 that a friend of mine left me when he left this planet. So I thought I'd write him a song. Possible that Snake might have known this fella. Everybody called him Mad John. Worcester legend. Much like Snake. So this is a song for him. It's called Mad John. Yeah, get it right. I was a kid living on these streets. Took my guitar, restless mind and feet, to a small cafe called the Garden of Delights, to sing and play for tips and food some nights. The funky joint down on Highland Street was where the hippies and freaks would eat. An old guitar picker watched me sing my song, and a smile and a grin he took me under his wing. Play the old song, Mad, Mad John. Let the world roll on. Play the old song.
song, Mad Mad Jonah, grab my old guitar and sing along. Big mutton chops, a corn cob pipe, we sing and play morning, noon and night. Frank and Russ joined us in our songs as the new Memphis jug band we all played loud and long. Crammed in the corner at the bar and grill, Hennessy's joint, played and drank our fill. Till closing time when Richie yells clear, you don't have to go home but you can't stay here. Play the old song, Mad Mad John, let the world roll on, roll on. Play the old song, Mad Mad John, grab this old guitar and sing along. Sing, give me a pickfoot and a glass of gin, the stockade blues or a wild rover again. Mow on the ground, the old Tennessee waltz, smoke rose to the rafters as we shook those walls. That was long ago, John's dead and gone. After all those years I still sing those songs on his old D-18 that he left to me. With a tear and a smile I share a memory. Some bright-eyed kid now, he wants to know where I learned all these tunes from so long ago. So I tell him when I was your age I learned these songs from my dear old friend we all call Mad John. Play the old song, Mad Mad John, let the world roll on. Play the old songs, Mad Mad John, grab my old guitar and sing along. Grab my old guitar and sing along.
Yeah.
A lot of old songs today.
Thanks for that one. That was a great song. Okay, up next is Charlie, and is Melissa with us tonight? You need to unmute. I just muted you. There we go. Okay, you're unmuted.
Am I muted?
You're unmuted. I see Melissa.
Hello.
Great.
I'm not fit for prime time. That's why I'm off camera.
Well, at least you're here. That's a step in the right direction. It's good to see you.
Thank
whatever
you.
I could see of you. Okay, go ahead, Charlie.
Okay. I'm unmuted. Okay. This old town's filled with sin, it will swallow you in. If you've got some money to burn, take it home by the way, you've got 3 years to pay, and Satan is waiting his turn. The scientists say we will all wash away, but we don't believe anymore. 'Cause we've got our recruits and our green mohair suits, so please check your ID at the door. This old earthquake's gonna leave me in the poorhouse. Seems like this whole town's insane. On the 31st floor, a gold-plated door won't keep out
friend came around, tried to clean up this town. His ideas made some people mad, but he trusted his crowd, and he spoke right out loud, and we lost the best friend we had. This old earthquake's gonna leave me in the poorhouse. It seems like this whole town's insane. On the 31st floor, a gold-plated door won't keep out the Lord's burning rain. On the 31st floor, a gold-plated door won't keep out the Lord's burning rain.
Suit. Where's my green mohair suit? Anybody here ever own a mohair suit? I'm sorry?
Is Melissa going to do one?
Yeah. I will.
Good.
Thank you.
Great.
Okay.
Somebody reminded me of this tune the other night, so I'm sorry. I didn't mean to stop you.
What do you call the song? What type of song?
Well, I call it Drunken Gospel, but I don't know what anybody else would call it. Okay.
I'll start it again then.
Well, I should have been home hours ago. I always lose track of the time, so I'll just hold up this wall and try to recall a fact from the back of my mind. Oh yeah, I remember it began with a wink. You caught me looking at you, but don't ask me if you can buy me a drink. I know what you're trying to do. Lead me not into temptation. I already know the road all too well. Lead me not into temptation. I can find it all by myself. Have the best of intentions, Lord, I try to be good and stay on the path I should go. The harder I try, the faster I slide, till I'm back on that same dead-end road. Good-looking thing, and that might be the best proposition I've had all day. But there's no need for subtlety, Satan. Just get me behind me, and I'll show the way. Lead me now. station. I already know the road all too well. Lead me not into temptation. I can't find it all by myself. I can't find it all by myself. Thank you, honey.
Great song.
Great song, yeah.
So what do you think?
Find it all by yourself.
Does that sound like drunken gospel, kind of?
Drunken gospel?
Dirty drunken gospel. Drunken Southern church music.
Is that an approved genre on the online?
I would call that backsliding gospel.
Backsliding gospel. Yeah,
that's a good term for it, yeah. Well, I don't know how you can slide back if you've never been forward in the first place. Oh, dear.
Aspiring gospel. Well, you sounded great, Melissa. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Thanks for making it.
So good to see everybody.
Yes, it's great to hear you. I'm glad you're feeling better.
Thank you.
Okay, so I think we have reached the end of the list. It's my turn, I guess. So I'll try to finish things off with my ode to this time of year. When endless February yields to March's blowy bluster, and brighter days presage a change for lives that lack in luster, I emerge from hibernation, raise my head, look around, venture forth to wander streets of my hometown, navigate puddles, avoid icy flows, and discover frozen fossils in mounds of dirty snow, dirty snow, where once was clean and crystal, dirty snow, now sheltering a mystery of what will be revealed when springtime breezes blow and melt away those mounds of dirty snow. Broken side view mirror, crumpled cardboard tray, bicycle half buried, mitten gone astray. Here's a handbill for a concert canceled by a blizzard, and something I don't recognize. Maybe it's a lizard. And canine coprolites to keep me careful where my feet go as I walk the streets of town, past mounds of dirty snow, dirty snow, where once was clean and crystal, dirty snow. Now sheltering a mystery of what will be revealed when springtime breezes blow and melt away those mounds of dirty snow. Wander past detritus of winter in the city, contemplate the substance, the volume, the variety, that stimulates the senses, visual and olfactory, the evidence, the effluence of urban humanity. But looking past the grime and garbage, one thing I know, there are daffodils and crocus beneath the dirty snow, dirty snow. Where once was clean and crystal, dirty snow, now sheltering a mystery of what will be revealed when springtime breezes blow and melt away those mounds of dirty snow. Melt away those mounds of dirty snow. Thank you.
Thank you, Dan.
Thanks, Dan.
Very nice.
Okay, so the next one, open mic, is going to be two and a bit weeks, whenever, March 7th, first Monday in March. It will be on Zoom. I'm still trying to figure out when to try going live again. Probably May, maybe April, we'll see. Depends on if cases keep going down. But in any case, March will be on Zoom, March 7th. So, hope to see you all then. Thanks
great
for coming.
Great to hear everybody.
Hey, thank you.
Good to see you here, everybody.
Thanks, Dan.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Dan. Another great night.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dan.
Thanks for having me, Dan.
Thank you.
Yeah. Good night, all.
Good night.
Good night, and thank you.